Hey everybody, Carl here from Abt at CES 2020 with Brandon in the Canon booth. He's got the EOS 1DX Mark III with him here, and we're gonna go take a little deeper dive into some of the features that you're gonna get on this camera in regards to photography and videography. What do we got?
Yeah, so on the photography side, we're now dealing with a much more robust camera as far as the shutter goes. We're capable of doing 14 frames per second with the mirror down, shooting an optical viewfinder, and it sounds glorious. I mean, you could be shooting all day long, over 1,000 shots in a single burst, because we're now writing to a CF Express card. So this is a new card format, and it's allowing us to be able to digest all those wonderful shots you're gonna be getting out of this camera through those new card formats. We're now dealing with two identical CF Express cards, so there's no two different formats in the card. It's a single format. And additionally, that particular CF Express card is also allowing us to download now 20 frames per second in live view. So just when you thought that the camera was really, really fast, it can go even faster. One of the beautiful things about that is that we can now do electronic shutter in live view as well. So for those photojournalists that are out there, wedding photographers, people that might be in a press scrum or shooting a press conference, they're now going to be able to be shooting silently. Where you're not going to hear any operations from the camera side. Okay. You might hear a little bit of noise from your lens if you're using an older lens that has the autofocus.
Sure.
But you're going to be a lot quieter, not going to be interrupting a reception or anything like that, and you're going to get better shots that way. So as far as other options go, we added a new file format called Heath Recording. It is a 10-bit compressed image, and it's positioned to kind of succeed JPEG as a format in the future.
Okay.
So we're including JPEG as a format, but to kind of help to future-proof the camera and to help with other people's workflows in the future, we're now adding Heath Recording. So you'll find it in the fourth camera menu, in the red menu for shooting, and it'll be labeled as PQ.
Okay.
And it's kind of a newer file format for us. And there's the ability in the camera to actually go and convert that from a Heath file over to a JPEG.
Okay.
The big benefit here is that when you enable things like highlight tone priority, you're actually gonna get better highlight retention in your photos. So in those situations where your highlights might've been blowing out in the past,
mm-hmm.
you're actually gonna get a much better image overall because of that.
Wow, so without having to do anything additional, that camera's gonna process that for you.
Yep, so this is a completely new file format. It requires a lot more processing, so we actually have a camera that's capable of doing 16 frames per second, 20 frames per second. So we've added a new DigiX processor to it. And that processor is replacing, in the past model, we've had to use two processors,
okay.
which were dual DigiX 6 Plus camera processors in the 1DX Mark II. So this new processor is extremely fast, and with it, we're able to go and do new operations.
Okay.
So we added a clarity slider to your the camera. And similar to what you have in your picture style settings, which was a contrast setting, clarity is going to be edge contrast.
Okay.
And it's going to kind of be able to go and adjust your photos, give them a little more pop to them, give a little more sharpness to different types of scenarios. And it should be a welcomed addition to a lot of those photographers out there.
Excellent. All right, so some very cool features built into this. Can we talk about the video part of this as well?
Absolutely. Like I said earlier, this is the most powerful video DSLR that Canon has ever produced. Internally, we now have Canon log recording. We also have the ability to do various different resolutions. Our largest is now raw video. So you'll see that there's a 4K D setting, and you'll have the ability to select raw recording,
okay.
all the way up to 60 frames per second. There's also 4K DCI, which would be 4096 pixels wide, and that's capable of recording as well up to 60 frames per second, either a full read, if you will, so full frame,
uh-huh.
or there's also a cropped version of that as
okay.
well. Similar to what we had in the 1DX Mark II as far as the field of view. There's also a 4K UHD, so ultra high definition, that's available as well up to 60 frames per second. And there's also, obviously, a full HD setup where you'll have 60 frames per second with audio as a maximum, and there's also the 120 frames per second. So substantial amount of options out there for the our cinematographers that are out there. This is featuring dual pixel autofocus, so you will have the face detection, the eye detection that you all know and love. And we also added in the manual focus peaking and the focus guide that a lot of people love. And latestly, it's been added to the EOS R and the RPs. So these are great features that a lot of people are going to love. And for a lot of the videographers that are out there, this is a very powerful camera. And a lot of people don't know that inside you have a lot of audio options. This is one of the only DSLRs on the market that actually has a line level input on it as well. Okay. So if you're mixing to a board, it's a great feature of the 1D. And beyond that, anybody that's already used this, they'll be happy to know that we're using the same LPE19 battery.
Okay.
We've actually gotten a lot more battery life out of it. So for a still photographer, you're getting 2,800 shots now, a substantial amount of increase. And for video shooters, you're getting over 2 hours worth of video recording.
Wow. And so, is that at 4K?
I believe so.
Okay.
So you got a lot of different options. The camera's a very, very robust build, fully weathered sealed, magnesium alloy chassis. Normally when somebody's looking at a camera like this, they know that it's our flagship for a reason. And it's going to be a reliable camera for a very long and long-term investment. So for a still photographer, you're talking about 500,000 actuations here for a shutter life.
All right, that's some great stuff built into this camera, guys. You got to check this thing out. Make sure you stay tuned because we've got a lot more stuff coming up from CES 2020.